Hello, welcome to this video on how to play crazy high notes on your violin. Did you know that the violin is one of the highest sounding instruments? There are very few instruments that can get up as high sounding, as high pitched sounding as a violin. And the amazing thing is we can also do low notes, so there's this fantastic range. You probably know then, on your violin, the lowest notes are on the G string, like this. And the highest notes are on the E string, of course. Like that. And what I'm going to do is just show you a few little bits and pieces that demonstrate some of the higher notes on the violin. And I might try a little bit of Vivaldi. Okay. So you'll notice that most of the time there, I was playing way up on the E string, quite high up on the fingerboard here. However, there is another way of making high squeaky sounds on the violin, like this. Very squeaky and kind of surprising, isn't it? In fact, it's debatable whether that's a nice sound or not. Sometimes it's just a sort of very high squeaky effect and it's not nice at all, but it's interesting and composers often use just one or two notes in the middle of a piece as a special effect. So what I thought I'd show you is I'm going to play a scale and show you how I can climb up to some of those high notes. So we'll start on the G string. A bit higher, and a bit higher, and even higher. Wow, that really is a crazy high note, isn't it? So this is what it would look like written down. So what I've got here are some notes that you may recognise already. So look, there's an open G string at the bottom. And then it's climbing up, and then here are some E string notes, look. And then we're climbing further up the E string, and we add these extra lines, they're called ledger lines. And it's a bit like drawing rungs of a ladder, and then you climb up the ladder so that you can climb all the way up to the very highest notes. So I'm going to play that scale again, but perhaps you could follow it with your eyes along the page this time so you know what it looks like written down. Next bar. Next bar. Next bar. All right. So, there is another way of writing that though, because all of these ledger lines make it quite tricky to notice what note it is. It takes quite a lot of experience to be able to read these easily. But what you might sometimes see written down is notes with this dotted line written above. And that means that you have to play these notes here, but an octave higher, which means eight notes higher. So it'll still be the same letter. This will be a D, but then you've got to play a D an octave higher, so even higher up the E string. And it just makes it a little bit easier to read rather than having all those extra ledger lines added. Okay, so this is where you might want to consider getting your violin out, because we might have a go at trying to get up to some of those high notes. What I'd like to do is put a third finger down on the E string, and I'm going to keep my wrist and my elbow very loose and floppy. And then with my third finger, I'm just going to slide up and down like that. It sounds exactly like a car alarm, doesn't it? Never mind. But it's quite a cool effect. And then what I'm going to do this time is go up even further. And in order to do that, I'm going to bring my elbow quite far forward, swing it forward like that. And then my thumb can come underneath the neck of the violin like that. And then I'll be able to reach the very top note. So we've gone from car alarms to sounds like, just like a sort of fire engine or something. So go on, why don't you drive your neighbours mad by making lots of car alarm and fire engine sounds? Right, and that sliding effect is called a glissando. That's the posh word for it. And this is what a glissando looks like written down. So if you see a wiggly line like that between two notes, that means you've got to slide your finger and do a glissando. Now, earlier in the video, when I played Twinkle, I did say that it's possible to play some high squeaky notes, even quite low down on the fingerboard. We don't have to be right up here. We can do it low down. And I'm just going to show you how to do some of those. They're called harmonics. And what we need to do is press the finger in a different kind of way. So instead of pressing quite firmly, like you normally do, we're just going to let the finger hover very, very gently above the string. So not really pressing, barely touching the string, so that only the teeniest, tiniest bit of skin is just brushing against the string. And so I'm going to put a fourth finger on the E string, and I'm going to do that hovering thing. So I'm not pressing, I'm just very, very slightly touching. And I'm going to let it slide up. Nothing yet, but there'll be a magic moment where we reach the harmonic. Ah, can you hear it? There's where it's ringing out. And if I cross over and do that place on all the strings, we get this very beautiful ringing out bell-like sound. Don't know if the video can pick that up, but it really does ring on quite a lot. Especially if you use lots of bow. And that sort of harmonic written down looks like this. So it's the four fingers, but played quite high up on each string. And then this little circle here is a harmonic symbol, which means we have to do that special pressure of barely touching the string. And you might sometimes see that occasionally in the piece as a special effect. Now, there's another kind of harmonic I'm going to teach you. And I'm going to put, well, I'm just going to play, to start with, my third fingers, normally, in first position, on each string. And that's with normal pressing down quite firmly. But if I do our new hovering above the string very lightly harmonic effect, we get that ringing out sound. So this is pressing normally, quite firmly. And then the same finger, but just hovering, makes that very squeaky ringing sound. So have a go at that. You can now play some high notes and you can do some harmonics. That's when they write that kind of harmonic. It's written like that. So you see this note here, instead of being a circle, it's a square or a diamond. And that indicates that you have to press very lightly to make it a harmonic. And there's another kind called a false harmonic, which is a bit more complicated because you have to press two fingers at once on the same string. So in this example, there's a one pressed very firmly on the A string. It's a B. And then the fourth finger is very lightly going to press on the harmonic. I'll show you what that looks like. So you see I've got one press down, and then the forefinger just very lightly touching the string. And you have to have your forefinger stretched out quite straight and firm. You can't sort of be like this, otherwise it won't be in tune. It has to be stretched up. And there's that same place on each string. Makes another harmonic note. And when I played Twinkle earlier, those were some of the notes I was using. Lovely. So the last thing I was going to show you is some suggested listening to some very cool videos on YouTube. I'm afraid I don't know how to do the proper linking thing. But if you type these into the search box on YouTube, you'll be able to listen to Nicola Benedetti, who's a very famous classical musician, a sort of classical mega music star. And she's quite young and cool and glamorous. And she's playing the Lark Ascending, which is extremely beautiful, and it's very high up on the E string, and it's meant to imitate birdsong, a lark, and birds flying up very high. And then the other video is clips of lots of different people playing some incredibly difficult and impressive sounding pieces with harmonics in. So some quite squeaky, but very interesting sounding violin playing. So there you go. Have a go at trying out some high notes. Let me know how you get on, and see you soon. Bye.